honestly, the truth is that you've been an actor. And now your actions got them boys about to mass up. Lectures from the devil got you piping hot. This up and you get screwed and chopped, no Michael Watts. When I was 10, I knew I should have been on Rap a Lot. Think like Jay Prince and I do more than just rap a lot. Listen, I went and got my digits up. Listen, your favorite, bruh. Listen, you don't want no trouble, cuh. The 25th, I got a meeting with the governor. That's real rap a lot, no cap a lot. I used to from Farron down to Camelot. I used to whip up in my granny's pot. She asked my friends, was I? They said, no, be not. The mind to a praying woman. The truth's a heavy burden and it's weighing on me. Red Dog has caught me slipping with the wailing on me. I went to calling out for Jesus like a reverend on me. Chopped it up to sin, took it on my chin. Gotta take some L's if you wanna win. They took a but then take a sin. I didn't even have no re-up I could re-up with. Had to rob another just to re-up. Pray to God it in his heart, he found forgiveness for me. It was nothing personal, it was just business for me. When I got on, I paid him back and told him it was ugly. I'd rather ask for than be asking for permission in a beggar's line. Cause of who I be and check out how I tend to mine. I got a partner who don't eat no.
From beautiful South Florida, there's a look at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami. The excitement brewing here in South Florida. As a moment ago, the Dolphins starters were introduced to this home crowd. They're fired up as well as they get set to match up with the New Orleans Saints. As of this morning, summer officially over. It's time for autumn football, and we're underway on EA Sports. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line. First carry for Derrick Henry. First down and much more for Henry. Pushing his way through. And finally brought down at the 31-yard line. 44 yards on the ground for him so far. And we were down on the field watching Henry warm up before the game. He's a big man. No wonder he breaks those tackles.
And you remember what I told you when we were watching? It's not all pads. Yeah. I mean, you get him out of pads and just see him in a regular suit or an outfit. He is a huge human being and a lot faster than what people know. When he gets rolling, he's a lot to bring down.
They'll look to throw here on first down. Flush to his right, and he wisely will throw that one away.
This defense for the Saints, very strong last week as they helped their squad improve to 2-0 on the young season.
And what I saw on film was a nearly unstoppable pass rush. 5 sacks last week, plenty of hurries given up. So now what do you do on offense? You just max protect, keep everyone in and run the ball, or maybe just 1 or 2 receiver routes in order to try and keep your quarterback upright.
24 is the mic. 19-9. He'll try again with the arm here on second down, eluding the pressure right. And right side, Henry's got it. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3.
Nice methodical opening drive here. They're already into field goal range. They're in a good spot. You know that people like to take a shot in this part of the field. But at the same time, as methodical as they've been, they might want to run the ball a little bit here too.
And just on the outskirts of the red zone, they have options now. Either way, though, they've come out with a purpose.
Third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's 4th down.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on 4th. Rolling to his left. Here's Fuller with a catch. Touchdown, Dolphins. Will Fuller, his his first touchdown of the new season. And the Dolphins take it right down and score on the opening drive. Jason Sanders now for the extra point. And that makes it 7-0 Dolphins. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. From the 10. Now a crease here as he's past the 30. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. Starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at their 35-yard line. And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of a full 8 yards. It sets him back for second down. They'll throw. He's got his all-pro receiver, Michael Thomas. And he takes it all the way down to the 28-yard line. A big-time play there for New Orleans.
The timing was absolutely true as he caught it working across the field. Plenty of space for him to roam. But notice how he keeps his head on a swivel, looking for defenders who may crop up out of nowhere. That turned into a big play.
So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Dancing to his left. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there at second down.
Nice job there defensively. A great time to dial up a blitz.
And give him credit under center instead of throwing it away. Actually, a pretty good job of getting past the line of scrimmage, not losing yardage.
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Oh, that'll be incomplete. Well, he took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a third down.
Well, to me, there is no question about the intent there. And I think he was a little fortunate that the penalty flag didn't come out for grounding. But he'll get away with it and get another shot on third down.
They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on second down. From the gun, it's a run for Kamara. And he'll get this to the 23, but that'll be well short of what he needed. The field goal unit's going to stay put on the sideline. They're going to go on 4th down here. They'll drop to throw. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Mike McCarthy took the gamble, didn't pay off. And the Dolphins' defense is able to hold. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. Now they'll be looking to duplicate the efforts of drive number one that resulted in 7 points in the 7-zip lead.
But you know how much I enjoy horse racing, right? Looks like they caught a flyer out of the gate, as they would say when you run into big-time races. It means they get out to a fast start. They're setting the pace, making the other team chase now.
A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. on second down. Here's Henry. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line.
Second and two is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
They'll look to throw now on first down. He's going to fire one deep left sideline. He's got a man complete. And all the way down inside the 25 before he gets out of bounds. It's a big play there for Miami. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. Tackle left with Henry. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
Second and five. Sliding out of the pocket. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, lived to fight another down, right?
They come up now, third and five, following the incomplete pass. Again to Henry. And he is not going to get to the marker as they stop him short at the 14. It's a pickup of four, but they're still a yard short here with fourth down forthcoming. Can't convert on fourth down, and the Saints will have the football back.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Flushed out right. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
So much for the best laid plans and best designed plays. That was good coverage along the sidelines. No place for that one to get in there. It sails incomplete.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. That is hauled in by Michael Thomas. And he takes it all the way down to the 28-yard line. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. So that changes things in a big way. Now from all the way down inside the 30, here's first and 10. Now the Dolphins are going to halt the action here. It's a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. First down, he'll drop to throw. There again is Thomas. They've gone to him a lot. Touchdown! Michael Thomas, his second touchdown on the season. And the Saints are within an extra point of tying this thing up. Zuerlein good with a PAT. And we are tied here in the second quarter. Kick it away. And
We'll see a return here from the end zone. And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25. First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complimentary football?
And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. A loss of four that time on the sack, and it brings up second. He'll look to throw. Escaping the pressure right. And this throw will be intercepted. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. Well, you don't want to coach him, Charles, to stay in the pocket on every play, but I guess that's the danger of getting outside of the pocket, extending a play, and making a bad throw. It turns into 6 points the other way.
Yeah, sometimes when you get outside the pocket, your vision actually gets obscured a little bit, or you narrow it down too much, and you don't see all the defenders in the area.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And they just had that pick six. I guess the only positive maybe of them returning that for a touchdown, this offense right back out onto the field to try to make up for it.
I like that because now it doesn't give them a chance to go to the bench and really settle, you know, to sit there and kind of seethe over the idea that they turned the ball over previously. Right back out there, it's almost like hopping right back on the bike after falling over. See if they can get the ball moving again.
Yeah, we'll see if they can do it here. Henry again on second down. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. 71 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here this first half. We've seen him break off a big run already in this game, and for a second, that one looked like it might be another.
Yeah, I think that any defense would say, look, we can't let him get to the second level because sometimes you'll break off the big run on his own, but oftentimes you get additional blocking at the second level, which gets you deeper into the secondary. Gotta like what we're seeing from him so far in this game. This is the third game of the season. He's already accumulated an AFC Offensive Player of the Week award in this young year.
Yeah, week two was his. The announcement came Wednesday that he got that award. He's going to fire one deep left sideline. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
Love the idea, love the concept, but you got to leave a little room on the sideline so he can fade into it when he makes the catch. That was thrown too close to it for the receiver to make a play.
Out of the gun now on third down. This will be caught. It's Waddle. And they'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
And now a fumble. The ball's out, and this is picked up by the Saints. And he'll get this back to the 32-yard line. Obviously, you got to hold on to the football, but I've got to give credit to the defense there. Good job of knocking it free.
Yeah, because a lot of the time we just blame the offensive players for not taking care of it. How about the effort of the defensive players knowing that guys are going to, and if they're good, anticipate the contact coming and try and cover up the football, and they still find ways to knock it free.
They go play action here on first down. They'll get this out to Kamara. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch, and it'll make it second down. Safety.
Again, this is Kamara. Looking for an opening, not much there. He'll get it to the 39. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other three here on third down? He'll look to throw. That's into a crowd and intercepted. Picked off by Xavier Howard. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
Flush to his right. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds.
Second and 7, operating from the 34.
They'll set up to throw. Eluding the pressure right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back end. Pass rush, they've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync, only way to play good defense.
In danger of squandering their great field position as they come up on a 3rd and 7. They'll look to throw. He's going to fire this thing deep right sideline. And that is incomplete.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after 3 plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
The offense going to stay out there. They've converted once, failed once. What can they do here on fourth down? He finds his man complete. It's Carson. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. A big play there for the Dolphins. Trying to punch it in with Henry. And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further.
Maybe I'm wrong, but it looked like even if he had opted to keep that, I don't think there was going to be much to gain.
Seemed like it was perfectly defense. And know what they say, those guys on the other side, they get paid too.
They'll give Henry another shot. A nifty move on the run, but ultimately stops short of the goal line down at the 2. The second down play, not much better than the first, just a gain of 1 there.
Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is 3rd and goal.
Here's Henry. And Henry fighting for the marker, but I don't think he got there. He did not. What a stand so far defensively, and now that's going to bring up a 4th and goal. Creeping up on 1 minute to play in this first half. Look to throw here. Flushed out right. Touchdown, Dolphins! It's complete. A great effort there. Hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season.
And the Dolphins are an extra point away from tying the ball game here in the final minute of the first half. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And we are tied here in the second quarter. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And not much on this one. Takes it from the 21. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And they've got a little under 40 seconds to go if they want to try to put something together here. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Steps away to his left. And he'll just get rid of it.
Yeah, that one sailed on him. You've got to make sure you give your receiver a chance to come down inbounds because they are very gifted. They'll make the circus catches, but they make them out of bounds. That does you no good.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. They'll set up a throw. Intercepted. Picked off at the 39. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six and a Dolphins touchdown. Well, dare I say it, it's kind of quid pro quo. Both defenses now with an interception return for a touchdown.
Your vocabulary, sir. Well done.
Extra point up and good by Sanders. And the lead is now 21-14. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And not much on this one. Takes it from the 21. And they'll be set up pretty nicely here as they have it up to the 35-yard line. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started as they take over with just 17 seconds left before the break. Oh, look at Thomas wide open. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime.
How about the first half he's putting together? Well over 100 yards already with that last catch. And to me, they'd be well served to keep looking his way. A number of big plays already in this one.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
So on second down, the field goal unit is on here as they try to get three before half. This is a 49-yard attempt, right hash. Zerline's kick is up and through, and that'll bring them back within four. So the margin shrinks there as they get the field goal to draw them a bit closer here in the second quarter.
Yeah, nice snap, nice hold. They just want to keep this game close, so give them credit for finishing that one off with three.
So still time for the kickoff here. 1 second to go in the half as this one is away. The squib kick, he corrals it inside the 25. So the two teams will head to the locker rooms here in Miami with the Dolphins on top. As we send you up to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. It's been a shootout so far. We'll see which defense can make the adjustments as we get back underway in the second half. Taken from about the 12. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And they trail here to begin the second half. What's going to be a key for them to get back in the game?
I think they're right there, and I think this game is still up for the taking for them, because we always talk about turnovers. They had two of them in the first half, and once you start talking about if you have three, four, or five, you know it's beyond difficult to try and win a football game with that. Those have to be eliminated. If they take care of the ball, they've still got a shot.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and six. Back to throw here. And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. Picked up by Xavier Howard. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six and a Dolphins touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Extra point up and good by Sanders, and that pushes the lead up to 11. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Taken from about the 12. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30, up to the 33. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And fresh off the pick six, they've got to forget about that quickly.
In this case now, the guy throwing the ball, he's got to be like what we talk about with defensive backs who get beat for a long touchdown. Short-term memory, right back out there doing the things that he does best, and knowing that taking care of the ball is paramount. Here's his opportunity.
Comes back to those defensive backs for the former DB, right?
I don't know where that comes from. It just kind of emerges out of me for some reason.
It's deep in there, right? So after the run by Kamara, now another first and 10. They're going to look to throw. And he'll throw this one away. I don't think he's out of the pocket. No, here comes the flag. In the pocket, chucked it away. Flag comes down.
So you got to move a little bit, right? Know where you are on the field. Have some awareness. Tackle to tackle. You got to get outside of that tackle box in order to get that done.
They lose the yardage, and of course, they also lose the down on the grounding call, and it's quickly second and long. Now back to throw. Being chased out left. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off near the 44. And they will set up shop in enemy territory at the 42-yard line. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And he's taken down here by the Saints. The defense rising to the challenge and setting him back on the sack.
One thing that I liked about this guy during the draft process was his motor. Of course, I loved his skills, but he plays hard on every down.
And that motor on full display there as he gets his first NFL sack. And he'll fight his way forward to about the 48-yard line. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Escaping the pressure right. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. And a little too much mustard on that one. It hits a couple yards into the end zone. A missed opportunity there maybe to pin them back. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Now second and seven from the 23. They'll run out of the gun with Kamara. And he'll take it forward for about five up to the 28-yard line. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. He'll drop to throw. The left side complete to Troutman. And he is going to have a Saints first down. It's a gain of six that time on third and two. That is catch number 300 now for his NFL career. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Now they'll toss it out right to Kamara. His blockers to get this up over the 40. So they'll come up after the gain of seven on a second and three. Again, it's Kamara. And tackled down after a gain of three. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
A 10th carry for Kamara. And he will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield.
Each team has its own terminology. Some people call it jumbo, some call it monster, some call it king. But it doesn't really matter. They brought in the big lumber to pick up that first down.
Yeah, you think about goal line defense with the goal line offense that time getting it done.
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. He's going to loft this one deep left sideline. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
I know he wants to get his team back in the game, but a 50-50 ball right there that maybe was a little questionable.
Yeah, he's pretty lucky to get that one back. I think that sometimes these quarterbacks play with a lot of confidence that borders on arrogance, and that can put your team in some dutch.
Yeah, especially maybe you want to look at some safer routes after the interception he had that ended their last drive.
On second down, Kamara. Kamara's got the first down and then some. And he gets this one down to the 24.
73 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
Boy, the offensive line there, that was a thing of beauty to watch them block.
I love how you give a little appreciation for those big guys up front, and well-deserved. But how about the execution behind them? You can see the hours of practice that have gone into it. Great pocket by the running back. Quarterback puts it right in the perfect spot. Great mesh point by them. The timing on point. The run even better.
A gain of three, second down. Looking to throw. Forced out to his left.
And he wisely will throw that one away.
Another throw there off the mark, and obviously he's battled all of the interceptions. Things just haven't been true to form for him. I don't know. What do you think's going on out there, CD?
That's a great question, and my suspicion is he's been coached really well to not show that he's having a problem. You know, they always tell you, no matter what, you keep throwing the football with confidence. Well, we're not seeing a confident thrower right now. He's off balance, the passing game's off balance, and the defense is taking advantage.
Three quarters in the books. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out. That's complete to Troutman, right side. But he will not get away. He stopped short of the marker. Mike McCarthy took the gamble, didn't pay off. And the Dolphins defense is able to hold. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. Now, there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Henry running right. Get this up to the 30-yard line.
It carries like that. That's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
Back to throw now on first down. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away, incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
Second and 10.
From the gun with Henry, and he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
The Dolphins on third down. They've had their troubles, just 1 for 6. This is third down and 12. Again, it's Henry. And he's going to come up a few yards short of the first. They get him to the ground at the 37. Give him 9 on the carry, but it's not enough. And it'll be fourth down. Flush to his right. He finds his man complete. That's Person. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. A big play there for the Dolphins. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. And he's going to go down. They get to him back at the 40. It'll be a loss of 10, and it'll bring up second. A shotgun handoff to Henry.
He'll get three, but it leaves him with a big hole here on third and very long.
That gives him 98 yards in this game, and he's got to feel pretty good about that, but the entire offense does. The big thing, though, Brandon, they've got to get to 100, though.
You think he knows he's at 98?
I think someone has told him by now, and here's the thing. Getting to 100 or more is tangible evidence that you've had a nice day running the football, and that's what his offensive line wants for him and for themselves.
Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. A long way to go here on third down for the eighth play of the drive. He's going to let this one go deep. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
As his old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
The kick by Sanders is good. And that will get the lead up to 14.
So that maybe not a knockout blow, but I suppose certainly every little bit helps when you're trying to salt one away in the fourth.
Well, the possibility of being beaten by two late touchdowns or at least sent to overtime does exist. But time, definitely a big factor at this stage of the game, is in their favor.
And not much on this one. Takes it from the 21. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. Now a play fake here on first down. And incomplete on the deep ball.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. Out of the backfield, that's complete to Kamara. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. You cannot write these guys off just yet, not with a quarterback like that under center.
You mean it actually crossed your mind with him running the team that you could actually maybe write this game off?
Not yet.
Not a chance. Not with him. We've seen it too many times.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Eluding the pressure right. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Late in the game, defense trying to avoid a big play. He's able to work out of the passing game, turn it into a run, pick up the first, and stop the clock as well.
And you know in this situation, everything is sped up. The intensity, the thinking, everyone's movement. But for a quarterback, he has to continue to be what we call a flatliner. Level in everything he does and read the clock, feel it in the pocket, and go at the appropriate time.
7 yards, the pickup there. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Second and 3. Throwing left side, it's complete. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins' 13-yard line. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. Flushed out right. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away. Got out of the pocket. Didn't look like he had anybody open, Charles, so just gets rid of it.
And a good play by him. If no one's open and you don't have a running lane that you want to take,
Make the right choice. Get rid of it. Live to fight another down.
Again, he'll drop to throw. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete.
And a nice pickup there as he'll get about nine, and that will lead us to a stoppage here at the two-minute warning.
So it's Saints football as we get you reset. They face a third down now as they try to find a late score. Here's Kamara trying to run for it. And he is in for the score. Touchdown, New Orleans. Alvin Kamara, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Saints have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. They do tack on the extra point as well. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter.
Now following the touchdown, Hoff-Richter to kick off.
And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive.
And this game not quite over yet. And we'll likely see them take all three timeouts defensively, so they can't just kneel this one out. They're going to have to try to run a few plays.
You're exactly right. They've got to get a first down and make them use up all their timeouts in order to feel like they have this one in hand.
Here's second and 10.
They'll run it again with Henry. Pushes him over. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39.
112 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long.
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Now it looks like he'll throw here. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game.
A CD, a little bit of feast or famine for him. He's had some success throwing the football, but also now he's been sacked four times.
Yeah, you just mentioned the four sacks, but you're right. He has managed to hang in there and make plays at times. His offensive line, they've got to figure it out and pick things up and give him more opportunities. And he has to help them by getting rid of the ball a little bit quicker as well.
Buying time to his left. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. He's letting this one go for Fuller. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
There is something to a game plan when trying to keep a defense honest with a guy with that type of speed. You do so. Send him deep. Try to throw some air under it and hope you connect downfield. On that play, they were unsuccessful.
This is taken at the 18. A big kick that time, 52 yards. And the Saints will take over with a first down and 10. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. One possession game, time very much a factor. How does the offense handle this situation?
What a lot.
And my goodness, another interception. He's picked off near his own 48. He's at it again, Charles. He had the pick six last week. Not a pick six here, but an interception.
And it's another OSCE, because that's the word we use when we intercept a pass. OSCE tells your team to rally around and block for you. Well, that worked really well last week because he had made it all the way to the end zone. This week he got the OSCE, maybe not a touchdown, but boy, he's playing really well.
credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine. Down to a knee here. The defense still with a couple of timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number two, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the ballgame. And for the Saints here on third down, an extra defensive back on the field. Victory very likely now for the Dolphins as they take a knee here. Now the Saints will use their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 13 seconds left to play. The Dolphins will send out the punter now as he's on here to punt it away. And a nice job here on special teams. This will be down inside the 10 at the 8-yard line.
I absolutely love the flexibility of these punters. Their leg drive, able to get it way up in the air, and that allows their punt team to get down there and down it inside the 10 because they've had some time.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. Critical condition here, obviously. Got to hope to get something quick right and then maybe take that shot deep.
And once they do take the big shot, you've got to worry on defense. Of course, no one getting behind the defense to make it an easy throw. But nowadays, it's not just the ball being tipped in the air and people in the end zone in a cluster. It's that guy that's short of the end zone who comes up and ends up making the play because he goes unguarded. So there's a lot to think about if you're playing defense in this situation.
We'll see if they can cover all their bases. Well, going into the final play in this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play. We're still, you're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.
So for Miami, it's back-to-back victories now after the week one defeat as they move to 2-1. And they will hit the road next week. Meanwhile, for the Saints, they too will exit with a 2-1 record. And they'll have a tough one at home next week against the Green Bay Packers. So for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. Next game, guess what? Charles and I will be here again. It's the NFL on EA Sports.
Shall come forth as pure gold. Have you been tried in the fire? Have you been tried in the fire? Well, tell me, did you come through as pure gold?
You kick it like the benefactor's benefactor. Well, truthfully, we know you never been a factor. Well, honestly, the truth is that you've been an actor. And now your actions got them boys about to mass up. Lectures from the devil got you piping hot. This up and you get screwed and chopped, no Michael Watts. When I was 10, I knew I should have been on rap a lot. Think like Jay Prince and I do more than just rap a lot. Listen, I went and got my digits up. Listen, your favorite, bruh. Listen, you don't want no trouble, cuz. The 25th, I got a meeting with the governor. That's real rap a lot, no cap a lot. I used to from Farron down to Camelot. I used to whip up in my granny's pot. She asked my friends, was I? They said, nope, he not. The mind to a praying woman. The truth's a heavy burden and it's weighing on me. Red Dog has caught me slipping with the wind.
Thank you. again up in this. Entertain it for you. Come for my M's, you get this double double. Make sure you bubble in this game because I love the trouble. So watch your tone if you don't want to rubble. You pop, pop, like my, did you forget we know you're not with any inch of the real, real. So stop it. I ain't knocking your little hustle, but watch it. I would hate to hear that loud ooh. Jitty, jitty, bang, jitty, jitty, bang. Oh, them cannons rain, yes, them cannons rain. Make sure you vote already when you see the game. I thought I told you lames, we are not the same. Having some fun, why you out on your run? Taking victory, relax, I'm in the hood with the ones. Catch me out in Decatur with some meat and potatoes. Waffle House in Atlanta, I hit the blue flame late with them two-tone gates, who you know gon' face. I see them keep trying, professional imitators. Rep, where's the flag? Now you're making me mad. With 47, get down.